Very good afternoon, everyone. We welcome the Honorable Chief Justice of India, Justice T.S. Thakur, Honorable Justice Dave, Honorable Justice Keher, and Honorable Justice Chandrachud, who have taken out time for the inaugural function of the Group Life Insurance Policy. Thank you very much, sir. Can we have a round of applause for everyone, please? We're also very grateful to Mr. Nariman, who has also been very kind to be present here with us, and his guidance has always helped us come up with these policies. Sir, we are very grateful to you for your guidance, support, and all the help that you offer to the bar. Thank you. I would first like to just give a brief summary of what this group life insurance policy is. The Supreme Court Bar Association this year is very happy to inform that we are not the apex bar of the country only, but we are also probably the first bar association which has a group health insurance policy for all its members, and now we are starting with a group life insurance policy for all the active voting members, around 2,200 of them, which is, we got in touch with 14 companies who provide group life insurance, and after that we shortlisted IDBI. The best part about the policy that has been tailor-made for SCBA is that generally these group life insurance companies only cover people up to the age of 59, but they have been kind enough to cover members of the SCBA who are below the age of 79 years, which I think is extraordinary, and I think the other bar associations of the country would also follow and would also introduce this policy. Second, above 60 years of age, there was a requirement of going through a medical examination with persuasion from the entire executive committee of the EC, which worked very hard for 4 months. The company waived this medical test, and people who are above the age of 65, who are most susceptible to the problems that we face, they will only be filling a form and nothing more. I think that also will help us cover a maximum number of members from the Supreme Court Bar Association. Now, with those words, I would first like to request Mr. Nariman to come and say a few words, sir. You have always inspired us, and on this occasion also, sir, we look for guidance from you. Thank you.
Chief Justice, Honorable Judges, and colleagues, we are, as Gaurav has told you, celebrating Group Life Insurance Day. Thanks to him and the office bearers of the Supreme Court Bar Association, including my friend Mr. Sinha, we are only the first one in the country to secure a comprehensive life insurance policy covering all practicing members. But there was a little ambivalence in what Mr. Bhatia says, that are the three oldest members of the bar covered or are they not covered? It's a slightly moot point on which we might have to take the opinion of the Attorney General. I'm sorry to inform you that if we are covered, then I'm sure there'll be a slightly higher premium, because the three oldest members of the bar who are still practicing, Jethmalani, Bhushan, and Nariman, on behalf of all three of us, let me thank you for your presumed consideration and much affection. But, Chief Justice, I do hear the complaint, shouldn't older lawyers retire? I'm sorry, the motto of all three of us is that a practicing lawyer never retires, he only drops dead. But speaking of the dead, this morning I was just looking up this business of group insurance, and I found that the earliest group insurance was in Roman law, in ancient Rome, where they used to call associations like yours or ours burial clubs. So it was a group burial business, and it covered the cost of each member's funeral expenses and financially assisted the survivors. Now, I have been practicing here since 1972, when the Chief Justice of India was S.M. Sikri. And I have always told everybody that he was the first direct appointee from the bar, having been directly elevated when he was Advocate General of Punjab. I've kept telling everybody, but it was only a few weeks ago when at a meeting presided over by the Chief Justice, at which some members of the bar were there, I was told I was wrong. The Chief Justice is to release this month a most well-researched book on courts in India, sponsored by him and by the judges, when you will be told that S.M. Sikri was not the first Chief Justice of India directly appointed from the bar, but the second. It's a secret who was the first, which only goes to show that the longer that we lawyers live, the more we lawyers learn on the more or perhaps what we should learn. I have been for long a member of this association. A rowdier bunch and a more unruly sect of people I have never seen. But I love this rowdy and unruly bunch, and I feel proud to belong to it. But when I first came here from Bombay as the first and additional Solicitor General, there was much resentment. Why was then a relatively unknown lawyer picked as law officer number 3 from Bombay of all places when there were so many more competent lawyers in Delhi? And the answer given was that it was because Nariman was counsel for H.R. Gokhale, law minister, in his election petition. And the answer was correct. My chief opponent at that time was R.K. Garg. But such is the camaraderie of this bar, which I must tell you, that he and I became friends and mutual admirers and within a couple of years, and we were the best of friends for life until his tragic death. Garg and Govind Mukoti, I don't know if all of you will remember, probably none of you do, but R.K. Garg and Govind Mukoti were the fearless champions of the bar in the dark days of the 75 emergency, when even the seniors were afraid to express their opinions. C.K. Daftari and S.T. Desai, the two senior most, used to say, would come to the library upstairs early in the morning, so would I. I once saw them sitting opposite each other, Chandubai puffing away at his pipe. You'll see Chandubai's portrait in the library number 2. And S.T. Desai, Sundalal, in holding his cigarette between the third and fourth finger and inhaling the smoke. And the following was the conversation I heard. Sundalal, Chandubai, bolo. Chandubai, Sundalal, tame pehle bolo. You speak first. This was my favorite emergency story, where even seniors were afraid to speak to one another. Garg and Mukoti were in a different class. They were, to use a cricketing expression, they were in the Bradman class for courage in adversity. One last thing I'd like to tell you, that even if we are all a burial club, I suggest we use this occasion to emphasize and consolidate and on the word group. The fact that we are practicing lawyers as a group is very important. A friendly but diverse lot, but above all a cohesive group. A group that sticks together come what may. Chief Justice, you will pardon me if I say that our judges should do the same. If they don't, it is only perhaps because no one is offering them group life insurance. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. May I now request the Vice President, Mr. Ajit Kumar Sinha, to present a bouquet to the Honorable Chief Justice of India, Justice T.S. Thakur, welcoming him on behalf of the bar. May I request Mr. K.T.S. Tulsi to kindly present a bouquet to Honorable Justice Dave on behalf of the bar, please. May I request Mr. Ranjit Kumar learned Solicitor General of India to kindly present a bouquet to Honorable Justice Kher, welcoming him for this function. Thank you, sir. May I request Mr. A.K. Ganguly, who is present, to present a bouquet to Honorable Justice Chandrachud on behalf of the bar, please. We welcome you, sir. Thank you for coming, sir. May I also request Mr. R.S. Suri, Senior Advocate, to kindly present a bouquet of flowers to Mr. Nariman on behalf of the bar, please. Thank you so much, sir, for coming. It means a lot to us, sir. Thank you. May I request Mr. Ajit Kumar Sinha to come and say a few words, please, sir.
Honorable the Chief Justice of India, T.S. Thakur, who has always been ready to accommodate at a short interval of time. We are grateful to you, sir. Honorable Judges of the Supreme Court, Mr. Nariman, who has always been with us, and all the esteemed senior colleagues, friends, ladies and gentlemen. Supreme Court Bar is a mini India, as I had already said. We coexist and coexist peacefully in a cohesive manner, and this group defines that. By virtue of this group, life insurance, we have justified it, and today with a sense of satisfaction, I say that this is the first time a historic thing has taken place. What we had committed, we have done it. So commitment for this EC means fulfillment, and I hope each one of you will feel happy that both the things have been done in the very same year, which is for the first time ever since the association had taken into existence. I'm grateful to all the members, including the secretary, Mr. Pandey, Mr. Sandeep Singh, Mr. Sharma, who all gave time, Mr. Manoj Prasad, Ashok Bhand, Rai, Ranbir Yadav, all of them sat together for 2-3 months, and both these things, that is the group insurance as well as the life insurance and mediclaim, all were through. Today we feel a sense of satisfaction, and you can also realize that the EC of 15-16 takes care of its members. Thank you very much, and give us a support. We'll do it again. Thank you very much.
I was hearing Mr. Nariman, and he said that the three senior most members, whether they have been covered or not, sir, I must at least state that our biggest insurance coverage is Mr. Jethmalani, Mr. Shanti Bhushan, and sir, your presence, sir, and no insurance company has the resources to cover all of you, sir. That is the difficulty. With those words, may I request Honorable Justice Chandrachud also to come and say a few words, please, sir. I have taken the permission of the Honorable Chief Justice of India. Thank you so much, sir.
My Lord the Chief Justice, Justice Dave, Justice Kher, Mr. Nariman, all the very distinguished members of the bar, I have a great deal of satisfaction this afternoon for the simple reason that Mr. Ranjit Kumar just whispered to me that I am also covered by the group life insurance by dint of the fact that I am a member of the Supreme Court Bar Association. So even though we are absentee members, I think there are some benefits. So that all the stress of reading 60 matters on Mondays and Fridays still leaves you with a cover of life insurance. This is indeed a very, very significant occasion. I must only share with you that in Allahabad, when I was there for 3 years, we had motivated the members of the bar to have a health insurance scheme for the members of the bar. And the importance of such a scheme cannot be gainsaid, because lawyers otherwise really have no sense of social security. We all work through our lives without a sense of any state-provided social security, and these kind of group insurance schemes are of immense support to the members of the bar, apart from everything else, to remind us that we are part of one great tradition, whether we are from the bar or the bench, of people who live together, people who talk together, people who discuss together, and people who have faith in each other despite our diversity and our different viewpoints. I'm really grateful to you for having given me this opportunity to speak, and to the Honorable Chief Justice. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. May I request Honorable Justice Keher to also come and say a few. As requested by Honorable Justice Keher, may I request Honorable the Chief Justice of India to... Sir, the mandamus equally applies on both sides, sir, so I'll have to listen. Can we have a round of applause for the Honorable Chief Justice of India, who's been kind enough to be here?
My esteemed brothers, Mr. Nariman, Mr. Sinha, Mr. Bhatia, other office bearers, senior advocates, I'm very happy to be a part of this function where something very historic is being introduced. Health insurance was already there, and now you have the life insurance also. I've been thinking that, you see, the legal profession has some fundamental problems. One is particularly in a place like Delhi. One is, of course, finding a place where to start from, chamber where he can sit. A lawyer must have a place to sit. I don't know how many of you still tell your clients, come and meet me in the library, because you don't have a place.
90%.
You have no address. I think 90% of the people must be, you see, telling your clients, you meet me in the canteen or you meet me in the library. So I think one of the very essentials, essential requirements for lawyers in the Supreme Court is a chamber. The next is a place, a shelter for your head. This is also a problem. In Delhi, you need a place where you can, you see, feel secure. You have a place where you and your family can reside comfortably in security. There is...